Welcome to TechEV.com, your solution providers. This is Brittany, and in this video, I will teach you about Apple's Automator software. Automator was developed for Mac OS X. It is a personal automation assistant, and if you know how to use it, it can make your life easier. It automates actions that could be repetitive, saving you time and effort in your work. Let me show you how to create a service workflow. You can open Automator either through your application launchpad or by clicking the Automator icon from the application folder in your Finder window. The Automator opens with a picker sheet where you can choose the type of workflow you want to create. Let's create the service workflow. In the New Workflow document, you'll find the Library column on the left showing a list of all Automator actions in your computer. The Action column in the middle displays available actions for the selected application. Make sure to select No Inputs for the services received. Let's create a service workflow for documents. Choose Document under Library. For this tutorial, let's try to automatically add a watermark to your document. Simply drag the action to your workflow pane, and it will automatically come up with a window showing the parameter controls you can make for this action. You can choose to add a picture watermark or a text watermark. Under Text, you can input the text you want and also customize the font type, style, and colors. What I'm going to do now is type in the name, that's property of techev.com, and then I'm going to choose the font, which is Baskerville. I'll set the size to default. I'll make it bold and italic by clicking on the checkboxes next to the items. And then you can also set the transparency. So I'm going to go ahead and select 40%. You can also change the colors from the color palette. After you're done, just click File and then Save As and type in the name you need for your service workflow. Click Save again. Now, every time you need to place your watermark on a document, just click on Word on the upper left and Service and select the service workflow you just made. Voila, your watermark pops up automatically. If you want to add more actions for your service workflow, simply go back to the workflow window, look for the action that you need. If you're unsure about a certain action, just highlight it and a definition will pop up down in the information box or when you click the action's description button. Let's try to change the document's font style. Drag Apply Font Formal Settings to Word Documents to the Workflow pane, and then using the parameters, customize the font settings. You can choose to apply changes to all text, change the font, the size, the style, the colors, and even choose through underline, strike through, emboss, or engrave. I'm going to go ahead and select all text, choose the font to Bookman Old Style, select the size at 12, make it underlined, and then also change the style to bold and change the color to red. After you're done, click File and Save. Go back to your document, click Word and Services, and click on the service workflow you created, and the Automator will automatically put in the watermark and adjust the font styles based on your specifications. You can do the same for other documents using the same steps. You can also create automatic actions by simply dragging a file to a specific folder. Simply create a new workflow and this time select Folder. In the New Workflow document, select the folder you want for your action. Now, let's try a folder that automatically creates thumbnailed images of your photos. Choose Photos under Library, then drag the action Create Thumbnail Image to your workflow panel. From here, you can choose the size and suffix of the file name for your thumbnail. Save your work by going to File and Save As and assigning a name for your new workflow. Now, every time you drag a photo to that folder, it automatically creates a thumbnail image with size and suffix name assigned. If you want to learn more tips and tricks about the Automator, simply go to the Automator Help window. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the TechEV YouTube channel for more tutorials.